Okay, this is part 2 of 2 for material overlays on an object. Please view the previous part 1 in order to get caught up and to the point where we need to be at this point. Okay, I've opened up 3ds Max in the default viewports. I am going to expand the perspective by clicking on toggle maximum viewport. Now I'm going to create a box. Since I already know the dimensions of the box that I or the material overlays that I created within Photoshop, I am going to apply that to this as well. So as a keyboard entry. Okay, now we have our box. You want to go into the modifier panel and right click in the area where it says box to make it an editable poly. Now we're going to assign our polygons ID numbers. So the sides we're going to make with an ID of, we'll say 1. If any of these smoothing groups are blacked out or selected, as in pressed down, make sure you press them down and unselect them. We don't want them to smooth. Okay? We want the ends to be group 2, and we want the tops and the top and the bottom to be group 3. I forgot to check these. There we go. Okay. Now we want to make this a multi-subbed object. So I'm going to hit the material editor. I'm going to select the first ball. We want to click this standard button. We're going to make it a multi-sub object. Okay, discard the old material. We want to set the number to 3. And this will give us 3 IDs. Now to understand where they're going to go, we're just going to select 3 different colors. And this, when you get a multi-sub sub-object with more like 10 or 20 material IDs, then this color coding will help you in the long run. And this will also see where our colors are going to be. Now, because it didn't do it, I don't understand why my computer wants to do this. And we're going to figure out a different color. There we go. That's what it's supposed to do. I don't understand why it didn't do it. Okay, so we know that yellow is a sides. And you want to ID them under the name. That'll make it a lot easier. Go to ends. And then top, bottom. Now, we'll go into the material numbers, select that, select this little button right here. We're going to select bitmap, and we're going to go to the default folder where I had saved everything, PSDs. And this was the end, I believe. We want to do collapse layers. And you can always check, okay, it's not the ends. So we're going to have to replace that with the side. click Side and make sure this is selected, Show Standard Map and Viewport, and you'll also want to click it in here. Okay, now go up to the root folder, and these are the ends that we're going to do. We're going to do this again, create end. Okay, make sure that's selected. Select, go back up, and this is the top and bottom. And there you have your material overlay width. Now you see, this actually was supposed, these slats were supposed to go this way, not this way. So the best way to take care of that is go back into this area, and you want to rotate. Oh, that's not going to work. It takes me a while to rotate things. There we go. And now we got the correct way we want to rotate it. Now we'll zoom in and give it a render shot, and to kind of give it a, you see how it's kind of pixelated in the render, it won't be so pixelated. There you go, there's your box or your crate, and it's all the way around, even on the bottom. I'll go ahead and render this all out in a large file. There you are. And to save a render that's not a video render, you can click Save Image. And I prefer to save them as JPEGs. And we'll just call this one crate.jpeg. Make sure the quality, I like to do the quality at best with a large file size and smoothing at max. And there it is. If you have any questions, drop me an email at timlew@tlc3dmodz.com. That's timlew@tlc3dmods. My last name is spelled L-E-U. Thank you and have a great day.